Hi there, Marius here with the Resuscitation Coach. In this video, we'll review the NRP 9th edition based on the 2025 American Heart Association and American Academy of Pediatric Guidelines. Our NRP review provides a brief overview of the NRP 9th edition algorithm. We highly recommend that you review the 9th edition NRP manual and become NRP certified if you have a responsibility for caring for neonates. Birth asphyxia is associated with both an increase in mortality and morbidity. By learning the skills of neonatal resuscitation, we can make a difference in outcomes. Most newborns make the transition to extrauterine life without intervention. Within 30 seconds after birth, approximately 85% of term newborns will begin breathing, and additional 10% will start breathing in response to drying and stimulation. To successfully transition, approximately 5% will receive ventilations. Less than 1% will require intubation, while 1 to 3 per 1,000 births will receive chest compressions or medications. Let's look at the top part of the NRP algorithm. As always, we will start with the 4 pre-birth questions that we need to ask the obstetric provider. What is the expected gestational age? Is the amniotic fluid clear? Are there any additional risk factors? And what is the umbilical cord management plan? Once the pre-birth and risk factor questions have been covered, we can begin preparing our resuscitation team. The NRP team will discuss the clinical situation and any management plans developed during the antenatal counseling. They will identify a team leader, delegate tasks, determine who will document, identify the supplies and equipment required, and outline how to call for additional help if needed. For the required equipment, refer to the NRP 9th edition equipment checklist. Remember that every birth should be attended by at least one qualified individual who can initiate resuscitation and whose only responsibility is the management of the newly born baby. If any risk factors are present, at least 2 qualified individuals should be present solely to manage the baby. The number of staff available will be determined by the risk factors. Consideration of the antepartum and intrapartum risk factors is very important. It's important for the obstetric and newborn healthcare providers to coordinate care by establishing effective communication. At birth, all newborn infants require an initial evaluation to determine if they can remain skin to skin with their parent to continue the transition, or if they should be moved to the radiant warmer for further assessment and possible treatment. This initial evaluation may occur during the interval between the birth and umbilical cord clamping. We need to ask the following 3 questions at birth: term gestation, good muscle tone, breathing or crying. If all 3 questions are answered with a yes, the baby can stay with the mother for skin-to-skin, routine care, ongoing evaluation, and temperature maintenance. If any question is answered with a no, the initial steps need to be initiated. We will place the infant under a radiant warmer, dry and stimulate. Don't forget to remove the wet linen. Position the airway in the neutral or sniffing position. To help maintain the correct position, you may place a small rolled towel under the infant's shoulders. A shoulder roll is particularly useful if the infant has a large occiput from molding, edema, or prematurity. Clear the airway if needed. Remember, routine oral, nasal, oropharyngeal, and endotracheal suctioning is not recommended. If the baby does not have apnea or gasping and the heart rate is at least 100, we should ask if there is labored breathing. Is there persistent cyanosis? If we answer yes, attach the pulse oximeter, provide oxygen if needed, or consider continuous positive airway pressure or CPAP. If the baby has apnea or gasping and or heart rate below 100, immediately start to ventilate and call for help if alone. Remember that the most important step in neonatal resuscitation is ventilating of the baby's lungs. Remember, PPV should start within 1 minute of birth, and then pulse oximetry and cardiac monitor can follow that. We need to ventilate at a rate of 30 to 60 breaths per minute. If the heart rate is not increasing within 15 to 30 seconds of starting ventilations and you do not observe chest movement, start your ventilation corrective steps of MR-SOPA. Based on your assessment of the infant and a clinical situation, you may choose the steps most likely to be helpful and prioritize the order in which you perform them. The MR-SOPA mnemonic includes the following 6 corrective steps: mask adjustment, reposition, suction, open the airway, pressure increase, and alternative airway. If chest is moving, continue PPV for 30 seconds while you monitor your ventilation rate, pressure, and the baby's heart rate response. After 30 seconds of ventilation that ventilates the lungs, as indicated by an increasing heart rate or chest movement, we will check the baby's heart rate response again. If the heart rate is greater than or equal to 100, PPV has been successful and we can continue with post-resuscitation care. We need to continue ventilating at a rate of 30 to 60 breaths per minute and monitor the baby's chest movement, heart rate, and respiratory effort. We need to adjust the FiO2 as needed based on the pulse oximetry and use the target oxygen saturation table. When the heart rate is consistently greater than 100, gradually reduce the rate of ventilation. Observe for effective spontaneous respiration and gently stimulate the baby to breathe. Positive pressure ventilation may be discontinued when the baby has a heart rate continuously greater than 100 and sustained spontaneous breathing. Don't forget to communicate with the family and perform a team debriefing. If the heart rate is at least 60 but less than 100 and improving, continue administering PPV until the baby shows steady improvement. If the heart rate is not improving, consider each of the following. Quickly reassess your ventilation technique. Is the chest moving? Are you ventilating at a rate of 30 to 60 breaths per minute? Do you have breath sounds? If necessary, perform the ventilation corrective steps. Adjust the FiO2 to meet the target saturation. If not already done, place a cardiac monitor for continuous monitoring. Consider intubation or inserting a laryngeal mask if not done previously. If available, call for additional expertise to help problem solve the situation. If the heart rate remains below 60, despite at least 30 seconds of PPV, turn the FiO2 to 100%, and if not done already, perform intubation or use a laryngeal mask and start chest compressions at the rate of 90 compressions and breaths at the rate of 30 per minute, which translates to 3 compressions for every 1 breath given. Review after 60 seconds. And insert an umbilical vein catheter or UVC. After 30 seconds of ventilating only and another 60 seconds of chest compressions with ventilations and the heart rate remains below 60, consider epinephrine. Epinephrine should not be used until effective ventilation has been established. Epinephrine ET and IV or IO doses have been simplified for educational efficiency, making it easier to remember. The concentration to be used in neonatal resuscitation is 0.1 mg per ml, which is 1 mg in 10 ml or 1 in 10,000. Our endotracheal dose is 0.05 to 0.1 mg per kilogram, which works out to 0.5 to 1 ml per kilogram. Our IV dose is 0.02 mg per kilogram, which works out to 0.2 mL per kilogram. Epinephrine can be repeated every 3 to 5 minutes. Administration of a volume expander is indicated if the infant is not responding to the steps of resuscitation and there are signs of shock or history of acute blood loss. We can use normal saline or type ORH negative blood. The dose is 10 mL per kilogram given over 5 to 10 minutes. Don't forget to consider a pneumothorax. If there is confirmed absence of heart rate after all the appropriate steps of resuscitation have been performed, cessation of resuscitation efforts should be discussed with the team and family. A reasonable time frame for considering cessation of resuscitation efforts is around 20 minutes after birth. However, the decision to continue or discontinue should be individualized based on patient and contextual factors. If you benefit from this video, kindly like, subscribe, and smash that notification bell. I will include some guidelines on the NRP in the description below. Have a fantastic day.